the ones that are 5 meters tall, they're sat on a 600 millimeter base. So we've worked out that I think that makes them about 13 times the size of the actual wand. We've been given assets from the film. We've taken a combination of the photos of the actual wands and 3D models of the wands. So the process for making them is, once we've got the 3D models, we mill a polystyrene version of it on our seven-axis robot. This then gives us the overall shape and makes sure that we're working to the proportions of the actual wand. To get the real detail within it then, Samantha, who's our head sculptor, she lays that up in clay. Once we've done that, we then take a mould of it using either just fibreglass or a silicone and fibreglass mould, and then split it in two, and we're ready to cast into it. All the wands are cast out of fibreglass, so the fibreglass gets laid up into the moulds, and then once we've inserted the steelwork, we close up the moulds and we're ready to move on to finishing them. So as we're finishing them, we're tidying up the seams where the mould has created a line. We're then painting them, and then obviously that's the point that they really come to life. The amount of detail that goes into each of the wands to make them look as good as they can do has to go into it. Look at where we've done the bases. The bases are actually made out of concrete, but again, we have to CNC some formers to make sure we're working within the right templates and the right sizes, and then sculpt it with clay to get that sort of stone feel. But obviously, they're working within quite specific parameters as to how we're going to fit all the electronics and the steelwork and the fixings into it. As much as they look like rough ancient stone, they're actually quite technical in a way, I suppose. The final process is then to add the sequencing of the lighting and the sound. We're going to use some of the music and sound effects from the films. So all of this will bring that real bit of fantastic beast magic.
Oh, it's beautiful. I was expecting it to be beautiful because everything with Harry Potter, they go the extra mile. It was definitely worth the 4 a.m. wake up call.
It's incredible, and I was really excited to see the different lighting displays they were doing.
I never predicted that people could make something so big and so detailed, and it's just beautiful.